Now let us see second order homogeneous recurrence relations. The second order homogeneous recurrence relation will be of this form Cn An plus Cn minus 1 An minus 1 plus Cn minus 2 An minus 2 is equal to 0, where n is greater than or equal to 2, and cn minus 1 cn minus 2 are real constants with cn not equal to 0. That means this should not be equal to 0, otherwise it will not be a second order. While solving the problems given this type of relation, first we need to write that in this form, in this quadratic form. That is, we will replace an by k square and replace an minus 1 by k and an minus 2 by 1. Here we have replaced by 1 here, so we get a quadratic equation from the given second order homogeneous recurrence relation. This is a quadratic equation and is called auxiliary equation or the characteristic equation. Let us see the solution part. We have three different cases here. First case is, if we solve that quadratic equation, we get two roots. In the first case, suppose the roots k1 and k2 of the quadratic equation are real and distinct, then what is the solution of the second order homogeneous recurrence relation? Let us see. The solution an is given by this in this case, that is when the roots are real and distinct, where a and b are arbitrary real constants. Let us take the case 2. If the roots k1 and k2 of equation 2 are real and equal with k as common value, suppose the equal roots are some k, then how do we write the solution of the second order homogeneous recurrence relation? The solution is given by this: an is equal to a plus bn into k to the power n. Here k is the root which is common, which is same, repeated root, which is the repeated root. Now case 3, the two roots k1 and k2 of equation 2 are complex. When the roots are complex roots, then k1 and k2 are complex conjugates of each other. That means one will be with plus and other will be with minus. Suppose these are the complex roots of the quadratic equation. The solution an is given by r to the power n into a cos theta plus b sin theta, sorry, a cos n theta plus b sin n theta. N is there, where a and b are arbitrary complex constants. Where r is given by, it is modulus of the complex root k1 or the complex root k2. Modulus is defined by root of p square plus q square. Root of p square plus q square. So this is our r, and theta is found as theta is equal to tan inverse of q by p. Tan inverse of q by p. So these are, we saw three cases to solve the problems. So let us take up the problem. Solve the recurrence relation. Thus, for n is greater than or equal to 2, given that the value of a0 is this and a1 is this, two initial values they have given, we need to find the solution. Let us take up the given relation. Characteristic equation is given by, how do we do? We replace a n by k square, this by k, and this by 1. So what your quadratic equation reduces to? See here, we have taken a n as k square, a n minus 1 by k, and a n minus 2 by 1. Here 1 we have taken, that is 6 ones are 6 has happened. We have written the 6 as it is. K square plus k minus 6 can be factorized as k plus 3 into k minus 2. So first root is minus 3. And the second root is given by k2 is equal to 2. Now here we can observe the roots are real and distinct. Real numbers and the distinct. Here we got minus 3, here we got 2. So therefore these two are not same. That means distinct, real and distinct. So we are in the first case. Let us see how to write the solution now. The solution is given by an is equal to capital A into k1 to the power n plus capital B into k2 to the power n. Here k1 is first root, that is minus 3, and k2 is the second root, which is 2. Let us substitute here. So in the place of k1 we write minus 3, in the place of k2 we write 2. And since they have given the value of a0 and a1, let us make use of these two initial values to find what are these arbitrary constants. Since a0 value is given as minus 1, let us replace in this relation wherever n is there by 0, so that the value of a0 can be expressed. So here if we take n is equal to 0, we get a0, and minus 3 to the power 0 if we take, it is 1. So we have written a into 1 here. And similarly if we take n is equal to 0 here, 2 to the power 0 will be 1. So we have written 1 here. So we got, what we got, a0 is equal to a plus b. Then in the next step we will substitute in the place of a0 minus 1, and we get one equation. Similarly if we put in the place of n 1 everywhere, 1 here and here and here, we get this relation, a1 is equal to minus 3, because 3 to the power 1, minus 3 to the power 1, minus 3 to the power 1 will be minus 3 into a, plus 2 to the power 1 will be 2 into b. We have written. Now let us substitute the values of a0 and a1 in these two equations and solve for capital A and capital B. Yes, we have put the value of E0 here and we have put the value of A1 here. If we solve these two equations simultaneously, we will find the values of capital A and capital B as capital A will be equal to minus 2 and capital B will be equal to plus 1. Therefore, we have used the values in that solution. Here the value of A we have used minus 2 and the value of B we have used 1, which is not shown here. So this is our solution.